Hello and welcome to the part number 41 of the Node Editor tutorial series. My name is Pavel Křupala from blenderfig.com and today in this part we are going to create something like a registration for our custom classes for our calculator node example. So we can later ask according to the operation code which kind of a class should I instantiate or create in our example. So as you can see, we will be able to have different classes and different types and being able to instantiate them. So I hope you are excited and let's start coding. Now we are creating the calc node here on this single place and it's always calc node. However, I do not want to implement all of the differences in one single class, in one single file. You can easily imagine that we can have, for example, 50 of the nodes and each of them will differ a little bit. So in that case, it would be nice to have something like a subdirectory with, let's call it nodes, for example, and then there in each separate file, there would be a class. However, we need somehow to define how to get a class from our OP code. And therefore, we can go to calculator configuration and we can have something like a dictionary. Let's call it calc underscore nodes. By default, that's going to be empty dictionary. And once we create a class in, for example, a file, I will for now, I will create just a single file. Let's call it calc conf nodes to have all of the nodes, all of the classes in one file, instead of the directory, because we will change it throughout the development. And here, when I define a class, once I import this file, we should call something like register node or something, which would actually put it to our calculator nodes. The function for that could be really simple. Let's call it define register node with OP code and class reference. And we can say simply calc nodes op code equals to class reference. However, it could happen that you are trying to register different class references to the same operation code. And that's something which we definitely do not want. So we can raise an exception once this happens. And instead of just deriving from the classic exception, we can call it, we can create a new set of exceptions which we are going to use throughout the calculator. And we can call them, for example, I don't know, for now in this file, it makes sense to have something like a global configuration exception. This one will extend from exception. And in our case, we can create invalid node registration, which will derive now from configuration exception. So in case that OP code is already in calc nodes, we can raise invalid node registration and we can say duplicit node registration of something. There is already something else. So OP code and calc nodes OP code. Can write it like this and the register node will raise an exception. So if I go to the calculate node, we can from examples.example calculator configuration import everything. Also we can from examples.example calculator node base import everything. And we can say that, for example, class is going to be named calcNode underscore add. And this is going to be the name of the operation, which we are using also for the OP code. This will derive from calculatorNode. And in our case, we just need to re-implement the constructor. For now, or basically, we can take just the scene reference. This will be perfectly fine and we can call the parent constructor because we know if it's going to be add that we are passing the scene as usual, we are passing operation code, so that's op node add, and the label is going to be add, and if I remember correctly, here we do have content label, so that's the queue label contained inside of the node. So we can pass a plus sign as a string here. And now we should call something like register node and say op node add, and the class name is calc node add. So we can do it like this. However, I kinda do not like this this version of registration. So this is a way how to register by function call whenever you want. So it doesn't matter. If you put it in the file here on this place, once you import this file, this method will be called. However, it would be much nicer to have something like a decorator for the class. So we could say register node, for example op node add, like this, and this should be able to register our node also. And I think this version is much cleaner. However, if we define a new decorator, we can't have a function which is named the same. So I will rename this to register node now. We can go to the configuration, call that now, and let's create a decorator for that. That's gonna be pretty simple. So define register node, and it's gonna take op code. And the decorator is basically a function inside of a function. So we can define decorator. This one will take as a parameter whatever is below it. So in our case, that's the class. Not the instance, but the definition of this class. So that means this can be, let's call it original class. And here we can call register node now with operation code and original class. Also, we do want to return the original class. And here we can return decorator like this. And this way we should be able to just register the class with the decorator for the op node add. To be able to register it or to check out if we actually did register it correctly, let's go ahead here. Calculator window, this is init UI. This is basically the place after our application started. So if we got debug, and I see we do not have debug defined here, so let's say debug equals to true. We can print registered nodes, and we can pp, which is our shortcut for printer. Configuration dot calc nodes. So to be able to read this, we can say from examples dot example calculator, calculator configuration, import everything like this. Now when I press play, we got registered nodes, empty dictionary. That's fine, that works, because we should be also importing the configuration file with the nodes. So from examples.examplecalculator calc conf nodes, import everything. And once we do that, you can see inside of our registered nodes there is number 3 operation code for add is having this calc conf nodes calc node add, which is perfect. So let's quickly go ahead to the nodes, and I will duplicate this code and create definitions for the other nodes. This should be sub, multiply, divide, input, output. This is going to be without sign. And we should definitely change the class names also. For the input sockets, we can type inputs equal to empty list, and outputs is going to be, let's say, for example, 3. We could also write something like self.initSockets and pass in the inputs and outputs here. However, in this case, we need to have reset to be true, because if you run this constructor, it creates whatever there is, and by default there is something in the inputs and outputs. Then we would need to destroy the old graphical sockets and replace them with the new ones. So this would be definitely need to have the reset flag to be true. However, instead of doing it twice, we can just call it in the constructor. For the output, we can choose inputs equals to list with 1, and outputs, there will be no output sockets for the output node. So let's test if everything works. Yes, we got different classes here, 1 up to 6. That's perfect. And now we can go to the calculator configuration, and we can create something like a new method, and let's call it get class from OP code and pass in the OP code. We can ask again if OP code that this time is not in calc nodes, then we are going to raise exception again. So raise OP code not registered, for example, OP code percentage D is not registered. And let's create this exception. Okay. And if we have some value here, we can just return calc nodes and OP code like this. That's perfect. Let's go ahead to the calculator sub window, which is here. Here we are creating the calc node. We don't need to do that anymore, and we can just say node equals to get class from OP code, pass in the OP code. That's perfect. And we will get the class. So let's instantiate it and pass in the self.scene like this. Just to be sure, we can put everything into try except block for any exception as E, dump exception E. Okay, let's import that. I see we do have twice the configuration imported, which is not necessary, but we need from node editor.utils import dump exception. And now it should be working. So let's create a new file. We got input. There is one socket, perfect. Output, again, one socket. And the add with a plus sign as a Q label, minus, multiply, and divide. Perfect. This solution would be perfect for our purposes and it will work. However, we can still do better. Once we are creating the global configuration here, we can use that even here, for example, in the drag list box. And instead of writing this manually, we can try to use to generate it automatically. So in our case, we could do something like keys and ask for the keys in calc nodes dot keys. And we need to convert that to a list. So I will write list calc nodes keys. Then we should definitely sort the keys because dictionary isn't sorted. And we can then go through each key in keys and retrieve the node definition. So we got a function called getClass from opcode, and we can pass key. And here we could easily at my item and ask for node op title. We don't have these icons there. However, we can try something like node icon. And the last thing is node op code. Instead of writing this. However, in this case, the node isn't instance of the class. So therefore, these lines or these accessing of the variables won't be working at this point of time. To be able to access these properties, these should be defined as a static properties. So icon equals to icons at png, etc. However, the rest of the code isn't using static variables, the class variables, like this. So therefore, we should ask a question ourselves. Is it able to change the properties of these variables at runtime, or is it not? In our case, we do not want to change the label of add, multiply, and the sign contained in the calculator content we are using. So therefore, we can switch these variables to be static class variables. And therefore, we can type icon equals empty by default. OP code is going to be 0. Also, OP title is going to be undefined by default, because we don't want to instantiate calc node anyways. However, to continue, we can type content label equals to empty string and content label obj name equals to calc node bg. So in this case, we don't need this anymore, and we should neither pass it into the constructor. So let's delete this and fix our call for the constructor. Now self op title will access this variable here, the class variable. However, it would be better to call calc node.op title. But once we derive the class and the class name will change, it's not gonna be the calc node. We do want to use something like self underscore underscore class to get the reference to the class itself and then ask for op title. So we can easily write it like this. And therefore, if we go to the calculator configuration notes, we can change all of the settings here by saying op code is going to be op node at. Also op title is going to be at, and content label is going to be plus sign. This has been removed from the constructor, so it remains to be just a scene. And since it's basically the same as the parent class, we can't easily delete this one. And the same thing will go for the rest of the classes. So let me copy that around. And for the input, it's gonna be a little bit different. So in this case, icon is going to be icons in PNG. That's perfect. OP code is going to be OP node input. And OP title is going to be input. However, we are changing the input sockets and the output sockets. So therefore, I will leave the constructor here and I can delete these variables. Same will go here for the output node. So this way the variables in the class are the class variables, and therefore this class doesn't need to be instantiated to be able to access these properties here. Let's try to run the code. We got input, output, add, subtract, multiply, and divide. We are missing the icon. I guess that's because this should be divide. Yes, that's right. So let's go ahead and clean up the code now. In the drag list box, we don't need these lines here. We don't need this print. And that should be everything. So let's close it. In the node base, everything looks right. Let's check out the node graphic node. Since here is a function called initSockets and that's empty, we are not using that. So therefore I'm going to delete that. Here is initSockets, we don't need that. In the calculator window, we can disable the debug and the rest should be okay. In the calculator sub-window, there's a bunch of prints, we don't need them anymore. Here we can type if debug and define the debug. Okay. Here we are creating the node from the class, that's right. However, if we do such an action, the create a node, then we should definitely store it to the history. So self.scene.history, store history, and let's call that created node. And we can pass the name of the node or of the class we are creating. That's gonna be node. We can access underscore underscore class. And this will return the whole string, whole path. So we are interested just in the name. So we can write it like this. Also, we don't need this calc node anymore. This file is okay, and close all others. This is the last file, and this looks okay. So I guess this is going to be everything for this part. I thank you for watching and see you at the next part.